So you have a cuckoo clock that you want to replace the movement. I'm about to show you how to do it. First thing you need to do is just pick up a cuckoo clock movement that's similar. I'll show you in a second.
I show you
how
the back.
I'm gonna just go ahead and take off the hands before I forget. It's kind of a pain in the butt if you forget and you remove the screws in the back, and then the movement is hanging there by that little.
Okay, here we go. We're gonna take this nut off.
Always look to see how the hardware is being held together.
Kind of
an easy way for me to do it. I just set up a couple of machinist blocks because the mounting straps stop you from laying it flat on a table. Also, make sure that none of the links are on top of each other. You know, kind of weird. They have to be nice and straight like that, because as you run it through the movement, any kind of links that are bound up with each other will get jammed. Okay, we're gonna do the first one. You know, these hands are kind of dirty. Let's clean them up. You use the same principle as before. You just put a little cleaner on a paper towel. Let's get some fresh cleaner. One. And that's two. Make sure you get the cleaner out of this little.
Let's see if I can juggle this the right way. I set it up so when I pull this chain right here.
Look at that, it's a steel chain. I thought they were made of brass. When this guy lifts, he's not lifting high enough, so I'm going to bend this guy so it lifts him up even higher. And let me show you what it sounds like when it's not lifting up high enough. Okay, let's pull that chain again, and okay, I've adjusted it. It's much closer. Put it on a test wall, and the clock is out of beat, meaning that it has to be crooked in order for it to tick-tock correctly. Let's see if you can hear it. The movement itself is actually sitting crooked inside the case, so the manufacturer had put it in crooked. But that's what's nice about the crutch, is that you can bend that black piece of wire.
On the test wall right now, I have it level, and you may wonder how on earth can you put a clock like this level when it's got a peak at the top.
This is Al Takatsch with Jefferson ClockWorks, and hopefully you can do a bunch of these for a little bit of extra money.